Thank you for giving me the time to speak on this
CP
important
issue. Ravindra Babu.
Sir, good evening, sir. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity, sir. Let me speak from this place, sir. I am actually supposed to be a study. Sir, this act has really nullified the double jeopardy created by the Supreme Court judgment. The Supreme Court judgment has created a double jeopardy, and a poor fellow who has submitted his check, for example, in Trivandrum, and suppose he was supposed to travel to Jammu Kashmir or some northeast where he has to go and argue his case for checking, getting the money back. One thing, he has lost his money. Second thing, he has to travel all the way from south to north to fight his case of check dishonor. So this double jeopardy, which was created in this judgment of the Supreme Court, is sought to be nullified with one stroke of amendment to the Negotiable Instruments Act. We wholeheartedly welcome this step, sir. This act not only nullifies the judgment of the Supreme Court by removing the hurdles and burden and the poor man who has lost his money and who is supposed to go to the place of territorial jurisdiction where he is supposed to fight, has been one stroke, it has been cleared. We welcome this step, sir, very much. And it also created two more provisions. There are three things pop up from this act. One is determining the territorial jurisdiction. Another is the defining the electronic exchange of bill or electronic check along the electronic digital signature. Third is the multiple places. If the person gives so many checks for the so many persons, the court will be determined according to the proper place as per this act, sir. Therefore, it removes so many hurdles which we have experienced, which cannot be foreseen also, sought to be removed in this introduction of these amendments of the bill, sir. We wholeheartedly from Telugudesam Party, we support this bill, sir. We also congratulate the minister for taking this bold step, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sri V. Vinod Kumar.